Hey, mathematicians, it's Justin again, and welcome back to Mathville Mansion. In our last lesson, we practiced building our problem-solving skills and unlocked this hidden ladder in the pantry. I guess there's only one way to find out where it leads. Time to climb. Oh, wow. This must be the professor's workshop. Check out all these materials. And over there, it seems the professor's getting ready to create some kind of tile art. I guess we're in for a new type of challenge today. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain what multiplication and division are, identify the parts of each type of equation, and apply different strategies to solve problems. Have your guided notes ready, and let's piece together this puzzle. I wonder what the professor is going to design with all these tiles. I'm certain they have something to do with our first puzzle. Let's check it out. You could count the pieces one by one, but there's a faster way it can be done. With just 5 groups and 12 in each, you know the product is within reach. Product. That must be the answer. So how can we figure out the total number of tiles? We could count all the pieces one by one, or we could use addition, right? There are 12 here, 12 more here, and so on, so we could record 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12. But isn't there a different way to show that we're adding equal groups like this? That's right, multiplication. Since we're adding 12 a total of 5 times, we can also record this as 12 times 5. That's because multiplication is really just a faster way of doing repeated addition. It's an operation that involves repeatedly adding equally sized groups. With addition, we have our addends and sum. And with multiplication, we have our factors and product. When adding, we can arrange our addends in any order. Can we do the same with our factors when multiplying? Yes. Since multiplication is just repeated addition, we could count by 12 a total of 5 times. Or we could count by 5 a total of 12 times. Pause here to multiply these factors and record the product in your guided notes. Twelve times 5 and 5 times 12 both equal 60, so there are 60 tiles here. And hey, we revealed the plans for the professor's next tile project. Are those gym weights? I guess it's time for a workout. Oh, there are weights scattered all over the place. And our next puzzle is by the empty shelves. The weights have been lifted, calories burned. Now it's time that each one was returned. With 32 weights and 4 shelves to place, can you find the quotient to fill each space? Quotient. That must be the answer, but for a different kind of problem. How can we figure out how many weights should go on each shelf? We could place the same number of weights on each shelf. 4 here, 4 more here, and so on. It's like we're repeatedly subtracting 4 weights from our 32 total weights each time. How is this problem similar to the tile puzzle in the workshop? It's another repeated operation, but what makes this problem different? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. Instead of adding equal groups to find a total, like we did with the tiles, we already know the total here, 32, and we need to split 32 into 4 equal groups. Which operation can help us do that? Subtraction or division. That's because division is really just a faster way of doing repeated subtraction. It's an operation that involves splitting an amount into equally sized groups. With subtraction, we have our starting amount, or minuend, and we subtract from that amount. We can't just flip them. The numbers need to be in that specific order. How is that similar to division? When dividing, we also have a starting amount or dividend. In this case, it's 32 total weights. Then we have the divisor or number of groups that amount needs to be split into. These numbers also need to be in a specific order, just like subtraction. This way we know to divide 32 into 4 equal groups to figure out our quotient or answer. We could find the number of items in each group by repeatedly subtracting 4 from 32, drawing a model like an array here with 4 equal rows and making equal groups until all 32 weights are placed, or maybe you have another strategy you'd like to try. Pause here to divide 32 into 4 equal groups and record the quotient in your guided notes. Dividing 32 into 4 equal groups means there will be 8 in each. So 8 weights will go on each shelf. Was that a splash? The professor has a pool? Hey! There's a key at the bottom of the pool. And I'm sure we're gonna need it, but I didn't really bring any swim clothes or a towel. Oh! A net! Perfect. Let's solve this last puzzle to unlock the net and scoop up the key. There are 27 pool noodles that need to be equally placed into 3 bins. How many pool noodles should go in each bin? And there are 7 shelves with 6 towels on each. How many towels are there in total? We've got this, mathematicians. Let's practice our multiplication and division skills. Pause here to solve each problem in your guided notes. For the first problem, 27 pool noodles being placed in 3 bins means we have a total amount being split into equal groups. How do we figure out the number of noodles in each group, though? By dividing. 27 divided by 3 equals 9 pool noodles per bin. For the next problem, there are 7 shelves with 6 towels on each. Should we divide or multiply? We need to figure out the total, so multiplication will work here. 6 times 7 equals 42 towels in total. And look at that! We unlocked the net. Excellent. We have the key to the next door, and I didn't have to get all wet to get it. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that this mansion is just full of surprises? Well, now you know that multiplication is an operation that involves repeatedly adding the same number, while division is an operation that involves splitting an amount into equally sized groups. Multiplication equations include factors that can be multiplied in either order to equal a product, and division equations include a dividend that is divided by a divisor to equal a quotient. You also know there are several ways to solve multiplication and division problems. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with multiplication and division. What was that? I know that voice. We'll find out where this key leads and catch up with Mia in our next lesson. Until then, remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey.